Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. And hi. I Syed Abdul Rahman bin Syed Ahmad, teacher at SMK Kampung Gelam.
Assalamualaikum and hi. My name is Amshar from Infinius Magji. I'm here to talk about the design of the mangrove restore robot. I got this design from my imagination and also with the help of both our programmer Adham and our teacher Sir Syed. This robot works with the help of humans to plant mangrove swamp. So it does not work fully automatically. We choose this design because of its unique. So like you can see here, this is the place where the mangrove swamp will be placed one by one manually, and it will poke it into the ground. In front of this, we can see the StudioNo IR photo reflector, and this is the eye used as an accessory. While on the back side, we can see that this sandpaper that is used to grip the mangrove tree more tightly, while this one is used to prevent the tree from slipping into the wrong area. And finally, there are four colors of LED lights, namely green, blue, red and white. So that's all the information I can share. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum and hi, I am Hairizan, who is a member of the best team Infinius Magji. I will now explain about what the robot do on the track. Okay, first, when the robot start moving around 9 to 15 centimeters, it will stop and plant the mangrove by moving the two servo motor at the back. The servo motor will catch the mangrove transfer by the main servo motor and prick it onto the track. Second, when an object defined in front of the robot will turn around 90 to 100 degrees and continue plant the mangrove. Okay, last, if the mangrove was running off top or you want to stop the robot, you can stop the robot only by touching the touch sensor. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum and hi. My name is Adham Azri, the programmer of this mangrove restore bot from the Infinius Magji team. So I will explain about the program that I made to run the robot. Red LED will represent as warning, white LED shows the program runs smoothly, the green LED will shows there is no obstacle and clear to go, and lastly, blue LED represent a starting and finish program. So the first thing that robot will do, when you turn on the battery, the servo motor turn to 180 degrees, which means turn to upwards. While waiting the servo motor to turn upwards, the blue LED blink two times and the buzzer will sound at 70, 71 and 65 frequency for 0.1 second each. The robot does run if you don't touch the touch sensor or make any sound that the sound sensor can detect based on the volume that being set up. Once you have touched the touch sensor or make any sound, the white LED will blink two times, then always on. The buzzer sounds at 72 and 67 frequency for 0.2 seconds. If there's an obstacle such as concrete or tree in front of the robot, the white LED will go off and the red LED will blink one times, then always on. The buzzer will produce sound at 68 frequency from start turning until finish turning. As the result, the robot will turn 90 degrees to the right. If there's no obstacle, the white LED will turn off. The green LED will blink two times and the buzzer will make sound at 60 and 71 frequency for 0.1 seconds each. After that, white LED turns on and the robot continues its journey. When it comes to planting times, the two other servo motor will turn to 25 degrees, which is mean upwards. And the robot will stop and wait for 1.5 seconds. To give time for human to add the tree manually. After that, the upper servo motor will turn to 90 degrees, which means downwards. The other two servo motor turn to 130 degrees downwards to plant the mangrove tree. This program will repeat until you touch the touch sensor. If you want to finish the program immediately while the program is running, you only have to touch and hold the touch sensor. At the end of the program, the white LED will turn off and red LED will blink two times. After that, all the LED will turn on for only 0.2 seconds and the buzzer will sound at 72 at 69 frequency for 0.1 seconds while at 60 frequency for 0.2 seconds. After all the LED turns off, then the blue LED blink two times to indicate the program has finished. So that's all for me.
To all the viewers, I would like to give a talk about mangrove. Mangrove swamp are natural forests in the tidal areas of the sea. It has muddy soil and is evergreen throughout the year. It are one of the important ecosystem for coastal area. It also an available gift to Earth. Here is the importance of mangrove swamp. First, habitat and ecology of marine life and other fauna. The nature of the forest is quite dense and evergreen throughout the year, so it is suitable for marine life. The nature of its mossy soil with tangled and rice mangrove roots is a habitat of coastal marine life such as fish, crab, shrimp, shellfish, and various types of snails. Its constantly watery conditions are ideal for marine life. There are even other living things such as monkeys and birds inhabiting mangrove swamp. Mangrove swamp also is a breeding ground for migratory birds that usually come a long way to avoid winter. Third, natural sea embankment. Mangrove swamp with their emerging roots can trap salt and mud. The continuous sedimentation process will expand the mangrove swamp area. It's a low land area to increase but takes longer times. Second, buffer tsunami and strong winds. Robust swamp can affect the movement of wind from the sea. With coverage in coastal areas, strong wind can be reduced with a percent of mangrove swamp. Mangrove swamp serve as a natural fortress that prevents tsunami threats to more remote areas. Fourth, mangrove timber of various domestic and industrial uses. Mangrove swamp is already popular as a building materials, carport and fireworks. Its insect resistant and fungi resistant properties allow mangrove wood to be used as a pile for a building. Even some types of mangrove wood, such as Pisophora, can be used to make boats if they are old enough and mature. Last but not least, mangrove swamp forest for ecotourism. Mangrove forests are a national tourism asset. The tourist industry, based on environment ecology, is a popular concept around the world. Mangrove swamp is a tourist choice because its beauty as well as a habitat for some life. For your information, there were also reserve forests for mangrove swamp. It's about 589,036 hectares of mangrove swamp in Malaysia, most of them located at Sabah, but only 70% of them at Peninsula Malaysia. Because of that, we decided to make a robot that can mangrove swamp to protect the nature.
Assalamualaikum Enhan. We are here from Infinis MG from Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan Kampung Gelam. Want to say thank you to URC for organizing this competition. Us to join. Thank you.
Bye.